Dear students, today we shall study about hemipterans. Hemipterans are the true bugs. They are having leathery forewings or hemelytra, and the other half of the forewing is membranous. So they are called hemipterans. Hemiptera comes from the Greek word hemi means half, pteron means wing. The name refers to their forewings, which are hardened near the base, membranous near the ends, giving the appearance of a half wing. The diverse group of insect, that is Hemiptera, include cicadas, aphids, hoppers and water bugs. The insects in this order are extremely diverse in their size, shape and color. Many species are found on grasses and foliage of plants. Some are aquatic, few are predaceous on smaller insects. They are small to medium sized. Some are homopterans, which are having uniform forewings, and hind wings are half leathery and are kept folded below the forewing. Mouth parts are modified for piercing and sucking. Identification of hemipteran insects. They are Exopterygoton Neoptera with piercing and sucking mouth parts. The mandibles and maxillae are stylet-like and housed within the sheath-like labium, which does not take part in piercing. Both labial and maxillary palpi are absent. The forewings are either Hemelytra, suborder Heteroptera, or uniformly thickened suborder Aucoenorhynchia and Sternorhynchia. But aphtery is very common, that is winglessness is very common. The cerci are absent. They undergo incomplete metamorphosis, except in Aleurodidae and Coccidia, where it is complete. Legs are cursorial type. The front legs are raptorial, example Reduvidae and Eniococephalidae. Many aquatic heteropterans have hind tibia flattened and fringed with long hairs, hence they are natatorial. Hemipterans usually mimic several groups of insects like wasps, ants, beetles, etc., but they can be readily recognized by the suctorial mouth parts. The alidid, that is Dulichius inflatus, for example, resembles an ant, Polyrachis spinigera. Habit and habitats of hemipteran insects. Hemiptera are the largest and most successful group among the Exopterygoton orders. Many species are phytophagous, predaceous, and some are detritivores. Predaceous groups include some Myridae, Pentatomidae, Reduvidae, Anthocoridae, Nabidae, etc. Many species are terrestrial, living within the soil, in the caves, on the roots of plants, or arboreal parts of the plants, while some are aquatic and semi-aquatic. Hemiptera's economic importance. Many species of hemipterans cause both direct damage by their feeding and laying the egg actively, and are by indirect damage by transmitting disease-causing plant pathogens like bacteria, phytoplasma, viruses, etc. to the crop plants. Several species of aphids, leafhoppers, whiteflies, scales and mealybugs are well-known vectors of these organisms. They cause great losses to crop production. Some species are parasitic on animals and man, for example, the bedbug, polycatenids. Some species of reduvids, especially the genus Triatoma, suck the blood of animals and human beings. In South America, they are very important vectors of Chagas disease, which affects man. Some hemipterans are exploited by man for the production of shellac. The species is Keria laca. The dyes from Dactylopius coccus and the wax. Some species of Dactylopius are also used for the control of Cactus opuntia. Some Aucoenorhynchians, especially leafhoppers, planthoppers and cichlids, and some Sternorhynchians, that is aphids, mealybugs and scales, are attended by ants for the reward of sweet substance called honeydew. The collection and preservation techniques for hemipteran insects. Most of the active species are collected by sweeping, that is beating the nets near the different kinds of plants or habitats which are to be sampled to collect large number of species. An aspirator can be used to collect the smaller hopping species from the net. Aquatic bugs can be collected by using aquatic collecting equipment. Several bugs can be collected during night. The leaf litter under the bark of trees and such specialized habitats need to be sampled to get some hemipterans. Collecting several Aucoenorhynchus and Sternorhynchus groups needs special techniques. The species of aphids and scales also need special collection methods. Pinning, mounting and preservation methods vary within the group, and some of them like aphids, scales and mealybugs and whiteflies, they keep varying. These insects need special slide mount preparations. Large hemipterans may be pinned and smaller ones mounted on the card points. Coming to life cycle or the biology of Hemiptera, the true bugs are undergo incomplete metamorphosis as they do not have a pupal stage. This involves passing through three life stages, namely the egg, nymph and adult. Eggs of hemipterans are fertilized usually in the spring. The female may deposit them in the plant tissue, soil or on the bark. Eggs could also be attached to the surface of plants or onto other objects, and they may also be guarded. After about 1 to 4 weeks, the eggs will hatch. The nymphs, after hatching from the eggs, undergo a series of 5 developmental stages called as instars. They shed their exoskeleton in between, a process called as molting, and as they progress through the instars, they increase in size and develop wing pads and scent glands for protection. Nymphs are very closely resembling the adults with respect to their physical appearance, behavior and habitat, but they are smaller and wingless. Nymphal development occurs quickly during the summer so that it will be ready to mature into an adult before the winter. Coming to adult hemipterans, the final adult stage may be either they remain active throughout the winter or many overwinter by hibernating. The mating occurs mainly through spring and during early summer in the same habitat in which a particular species lives. Courtship period is short and may involve a wide range of mating behaviors, including vibrations, sounds, and the flashing of brightly colored legs, wings, and antenna. It may involve the production of special chemicals used to attract the mates, called as pheromones. Life cycle of true bugs varies between a few weeks and it may last for over 17 years. Important features of Hemiptera. So, marine skaters in the genus Halobates live their entire lives on the surface of the ocean. They lay eggs on the floating objects. Family Pentatomidae, which includes sting bugs, have glands in the thorax. They emit a foul-smelling compound. This defense helps them to repel potential predators. Cicadas of the genus Megacicada are famous for their odd life cycles. Cicada nymphs stay underground for 13 or 17 years when they emerge in large numbers and with a deafening song. Females of giant water bugs come under the genus Belostoma, lay their eggs on the back of the male. The male cares for the eggs, bringing them to the surface for proper aeration or oxygen supply. Some species of true bugs can inflict a painful bite if they are handled incorrectly. Coming to classification of Hemipteran insects. Order Hemiptera was historically placed in two orders, that is Homoptera and Heteroptera or Hemiptera. Based on the differences in wing structure and position of the nostrum, these two orders were then combined into a single order Hemiptera by the many authorities, with Homoptera and Heteroptera classified as suborder. The order is presently more often divided into 4 or more suborders, and it was established that the families grouped together as Homoptera are not as closely related as had previously been thought. Aucoenorhynchus contains the cicadas, leafhoppers, treehoppers, planthoppers and froghoppers. The 12,500 species in the suborder Sternorhynchus are the aphids, whiteflies and scale insects. Suborder Coleorhynchus comprises of single family Pyloridae, which contains fewer than 30 species of bugs, and it is sometimes grouped with the suborder Heteroptera. Heteroptera is itself a group of 25,000 species of relatively large bugs, including the shield bugs, seed bugs, assassin bugs, flower bugs, sweet potato bugs, and other water bugs. The closest relatives of hemipterans are the thrips and lice, which collectively form the hemipteroid assemblage within Exopterygota. Fossil record of hemipterans goes back to the early Permian period. Homopterans appeared first, with Heteroptera first appearing in the Triassic. Coming to suborder Heteroptera, these are true bugs, and the wings, when present, are hardened in the basal half and membranous in the apical half. Thus, they are called as Hemelytra. The rostrum or labium arises in the front of the head. Tarsi are three-segmented, and rarely they are two-segmented. They have scent glands. Some bugs in this group, like Simicidae, Anthocoridae, exhibit hemocolic fertilization, which is sometimes very traumatic for the female. This suborder is divided into 7 infraorders, namely Enicocephalomorpha, Dipsocoromorpha, Gerromorpha, Nepomorpha, Leptodomorpha, Simicomorpha, and Pentatomorpha. Coming to series Geocoryzae, these are terrestrial bugs without hydrofuge hairs underneath. Antenna is longer than the head, and it is exposed. Rostral groove is present on the gula. The claws are apical or with Hemelytra with clavus, membrane, and corium. The first family is Simicidae or bedbugs. They are oval flattened insects. They are ectoparasitic on man and other vertebrates. Wings are reduced to scales. Antenna is four-segmented. Beak and tarsi are three-segmented. Pronotum with lateral expansions. Example is Simex lectularius. Hemiptera's economic importance. Many species of hemipterans cause both direct damage by their feeding and laying the egg actively, and or by indirect damage by transmitting disease-causing plant pathogens like bacteria, phytoplasma, viruses, etc. to the crop plants. Several species of aphids, leafhoppers, whiteflies, scales, and mealybugs are well-known vectors of these organisms. They cause great losses to crop production. Some species are parasitic on animals and man, for example, the bedbug, polycatenids. Some species of reduvids, especially the genus Triatoma, suck the blood of animals and human beings. In South America, they are very important vectors of Chagas disease, which affects man. Some hemipterans are exploited by man for the production of shellac. The species is Keria laca. The dyes from Dactylopius coccus and the wax. Some species of Dactylopius are also used for the control of Cactus opuntia. Some Auchinorhynchus, especially leafhoppers, planthoppers, and sick seeds, and some Sternorhynchus, that is aphids, mealybugs, and scales, are attended by ants for the reward of sweet substance called honeydew. The collection and preservation techniques for hemipteran insects. Most of the active species are collected by sweeping, that is beating the nets near the different kinds of plants or habitats which are to be sampled to collect large number of species. An aspirator can be used to collect the smaller hopping species from the net. Aquatic bugs can be collected by using aquatic collecting equipment. Several bugs can be collected during night. The leaf litter under the bark of trees and such specialized habitats need to be sampled to get some hemipterans. Collecting several Auchinorhynchus and Sternorhynchus groups needs special techniques. The species of aphids and scales also need special collection methods. Pinning, mounting, and preservation methods vary within the group, and some of them, like aphids, scales, and mealybugs and whiteflies, they keep varying. These insects need special slide mount preparations. Large hemipterans may be pinned and smaller ones mounted on the card points. Coming to life cycle or the biology of Hemiptera, the true bugs undergo incomplete metamorphosis as they do not have a pupal stage. This involves passing through 3 life stages, namely the egg, nymph, and adult. Eggs of hemipterans are fertilized usually in the spring. The female may deposit them in the plant tissue, soil, or on the bark. Eggs could also be attached to the surface of plants or onto other objects. and they may also be guarded. After about 1 to 4 weeks, the eggs will hatch. The nymphs, after hatching from the eggs, undergo a series of 5 developmental stages called as instars. They shed their exoskeleton in between, a process called as molting. And as they progress through the instars, they increase in size and develop wing pads and scent glands for protection. Nymphs are very, very closely resembling the adults with respect to their physical appearance, behavior and habitat, but they are smaller and wingless. Nymphal development occurs quickly during the summer so that it will be ready to mature into an adult before the winter. Coming to adult hemipterans, the final adult stage may be either they remain active throughout the winter or many overwinter by hibernating. The mating occurs mainly through spring and during early summer in the same habitat in which a particular species lives. Courtship period is short and may involve a wide range of mating behaviors, including vibrations, sounds, and the flashing of brightly colored legs, wings, and antenna. It may involve the production of special chemicals used to attract the mates, called as pheromones. Life cycle of true bugs varies between a few weeks and it may last for over 17 years. Important features of Hemiptera. So, marine skaters in the genus Halobates live their entire lives on the surface of the ocean. They lay eggs on the floating objects. Family Pentatomidae, which includes sting bugs, have glands in the thorax. They emit a foul-smelling compound. This defense helps them to repel potential predators. Cicadas of the genus Megacicada are famous for their odd life cycles. Cicada nymphs stay underground for 13 or 17 years when they emerge in large numbers and with a deafening song. Females of giant water bugs come under the genus Belostoma, lay their eggs on the back of the male. The male cares for the eggs, bringing them to the surface for proper aeration or oxygen supply. Some species of true bugs can inflict a painful bite if they are handled incorrectly. Coming to classification of Hemipteran insects. Order Hemiptera was historically placed in two orders, that is Homoptera and Heteroptera or Hemiptera. Based on the differences in wing structure and position of the nostrum, these two orders were then combined into a single order Hemiptera by the many authorities, with Homoptera and Heteroptera classified as suborder. The order is presently more often divided into 4 or more suborders, and it was established that the families grouped together as Homoptera are not as closely related as had previously been thought. Aucanorhynchus contains the cicadas, leafhoppers, treehoppers, planthoppers, and froghoppers. The 12,500 species in the suborder Sternorhynchus are the aphids, whiteflies, and scale insects. Suborder Coleorhynchus comprises of single family Pyloridae, which contains fewer than 30 species of bugs, and it is sometimes grouped with the suborder Heteroptera. Heteroptera is itself a group of 25,000 species of relatively large bugs, including the shield bugs, seed bugs, assassin bugs, flower bugs, sweet potato bugs, and other water bugs. The closest relatives of Hemipterans are the thrips and lice, which collectively form the hemipteroid assemblage within Exopterygota. Fossil record of Hemipterans goes back to the early Permian period. Homopterans appeared first, with Heteroptera first appearing in the Triassic. Coming to suborder Heteroptera, these are true bugs and the wings, when present, are hardened in the basal half and membranous in the apical half, thus they are called as Hemelitera. The rostrum or labium arises in the front of the head. Tarsi are 3-segmented and rarely they are 2-segmented. They have scent glands. Some bugs in this group, like Cimicidae, Anthocoridae, exhibit hemocolic fertilization, which is sometimes very traumatic for the female. This suborder is divided into 7 infraorders, namely Enicocephalomorpha, Dipsocoromorpha, Gerromorpha, Nepomorpha, Leptodomorpha, Simicomorpha and Pentatomorpha. Coming to series Geocorycea, these are terrestrial bugs without hydrofuge hairs underneath. Antenna is longer than the head and it is exposed. Rostral groove is present on the gula. The claws are apical or with emelitra with clavus, membrane and corium. The first family is Simicidae or bed bugs. They are oval flattened insects. They are ectoparasitic on man and other vertebrates. Wings are reduced to scales. Antenna is 4-segmented. Beak and tarsi are 3-segmented. Pronotum with lateral expansions. Example is Simex lectularius.